Let's keep on looking at the relationship between information and probability. Probability is just, you know, flipping coins. Heads, heads, tails, thank goodness. Actually, by the way, I have a legal two-headed quarter issued by the US Mint. Can you guess what it is? It's actually the New Hampshire quarter. It has George Washington on one side, and it's got the old man of the mountain on the other. The old man of the mountain is a rock formation that looks like a head. Unfortunately, it fell down about 10 years ago, so now they're putting a new New Hampshire quarter. I also have a legal US quarter that has five heads, and I urge you to consider what quarter that might be. So let's look at this relationship between information and probability. So probability, we can either think of it as something that's a prior probability. So the probability of heads is the probability of tails is 1/2, because there's no particular reason to choose between heads or tails when I flip this coin. Whoops. But we can also think of it in terms of frequencies, that if we have a long, long sequence of heads and tails, I'm trying to make this random, but I have the funny feeling that it's exactly the same sequence of heads and tails that I put there before. My students complain that whenever I write a random string of zeros and ones on the board, it's always the same sequence, which means it can't really be quite random, can it? Anyway, so what we can do is we can say, well, let's take a very, very long sequence. Let's count the number of heads and tails. Frequency of heads is equal to the number of heads divided by the total length of the sequence. Frequency of tails is the same. And then let's ask, we have this intuition that if the coin is fair, that almost all such sequences that we would generate would have roughly 50% heads and tails. Let me now make that mathematically a little more precise. So let's look at the total number of sequences of coin tosses of length m that have exactly m sub h heads, m sub t tails, and the sum of these two things is equal to m, the total length of the sequence. Now, the total number of sequence of this is a number that's called m choose m sub h. It's the number of way, if I have a sequence that's of length m, and I call heads 1 and tails, sorry, I was going to call it the other, heads is 0 and tails is 1. It's the number of binary sequences of length m that have exactly m sub h zeros and m sub t ones. Well, of course, these are the same thing, because if I've chosen the number that have exactly m sub h heads is exactly the same number sequence that have m sub c tails. So what is this number? This is the number of this is equal to the following. Number of ways of choosing. This is called m choose m sub h. It's a mathematical formulation, and it's pronounced to this funny thing with parentheses, with m on top, m sub h in the bottom. It's called m choose m sub h because it's the number of ways of choosing m sub h spots or locations out of m possible locations. Spots, I'll call them. So we have 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. I think I'm falling into the same possibility. We have a whole bunch of different spots, number of spots, and we want to count the number of places where we can put zeros here. So we have a certain number of zeros, and we want to put them in a particular way. Now, this total number is the total number of ways, the total number of sequences that have exactly this number of m sub h heads in them. So this number, I'll just write down what it is. It's equal to, so M, choose M sub H, is equal to M factorial over M sub H factorial, M minus M sub H factorial, which is equal to M factorial over M sub H factorial, M sub T factorial, where I've used this funny notation with an exclamation mark. The exclamation mark says, if I have a number, M factorial, that's equal to 1 times 2 times 3 times 4 times dot, 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 times M minus 1 times M. It's the product of all numbers up to M. So example, 2 factorial is equal to 1 times 2 is equal to 2. 3 factorial is equal to 1 times 2 times 3 is equal to 6, etc. They get big really, really fast, these numbers. So this number, M choose MH, M factorial is the total number of ways of rearranging M objects. So if we have a certain number of zeros and ones, we can rearrange these M objects in a particular way. But then if we have a zero in the first place, a zero in the second place, we don't care if this is this zero and this is this other zero, they're both zero. So if we have to divide by the number of ways of rearranging the numbers of zeros between each other, and that's this number M sub H factorial, that's the number of way of rearranging the zeros. M sub T factorial is the number of way of rearranging the ones. The total number of sequences that have exactly M sub H zeros and M sub T ones is the total number of ways of rearranging these sequences divided by the number of ways of rearranging the zeros divided by the number of ways of rearranging the ones. This is a fact. If it doesn't make sense, just suck it up. Okay? So, but now we have a nice mathematical formula for this number. And here is another fun fact. So I'm now going to define a probability. Probability, which is the probability of heads. This is, well, actually, I'll do it in the following. I'll call it Q, because we agreed before that the probability of heads was 1/2, probability of tails was 1/2. So let's let Q, we'll define this to be the number of heads divided by M. This is the frequency of heads, the frequency. So it's what we observe to be the number of heads, the observed probability, as it were, of heads, but it's just a frequency. We don't know if it's a probability. And 1 minus Q of H is equal to Q of T. It's equal to the frequency of tails. Okay? Now, here is the following, is the fundamental formula of information theory. I'll say it again. The fundamental formula of information theory. S for entropy, or I for information. It gets written both ways, because remember, entropy, this quantity that people discovered in the 19th century, is just information. Information required to label all the different possible configurations of atoms and molecules. In this case, we're trying to label the total number of possibilities of heads and tails. So this is equal to minus Q of heads, logarithm to the base 2 of Q of heads, minus Q of tails, the frequency of tails, logarithm to the base 2 Q of tails. This is a funny formula, okay? There's these minus signs, there's these logarithms, there's these probabilities, etc. So let me just actually write it out in a particular case. Suppose, just to give you a feeling for what it is, suppose Q of heads turns out to be exactly 1/2. So exactly half of the sequences are heads. And suppose Q of tails is the same thing, because it's 1 minus this. This is Q of tails. Then this quantity S, well, maybe we'll call it I here, because they're the same thing. Information, entropy, two sides of the same coin. So I is equal to minus 1/2 logarithm to the base 2 of 1 half, because this is 1 half, this is 1 half. And then we have minus 1 half, this is q of t, logarithm to the base 2 of 1 half. Okay, that's fine. There are two of these, each was multiplied 1 half. This is equal to minus the logarithm to the base 2 of 1 half, because I added them up. But logarithm to the base 2 of 1 half, this is the power to which 2 must be raised to equal to 1 half, and that's minus 1. This is equal to minus minus 1, because 2 raised to the minus 1 power is 1 half, and that's equal to 1, and it actually has a unit, it's 1 bit. So this formula, this, I won't call it magical, because it's not magical, it's just mathematical, but it's extremely useful. This formula says, if I have a coin, and I flip it, and its probability of heads is 1 half, its probability of tails is 1 half, then the amount of information that's encompassed in a single coin flip, if you like, the amount of information that's generated by the coin flip, is 1 bit. It happens to be tails this time. So, flipping a coin with the frequency of heads is the frequency of tails is 1 half is equal to, gives you 1 bit of information. Now, if we go back to our counting argument about probability, what we find is that the number of bits required to describe the ways of arranging exactly a certain number, m sub h of heads. Remember, this is a number, we're just defining it to be n. The number of bits required to describe this is just equal to m times minus logarithm, q of h, logarithm to the base 2, q of h, minus q of t, the frequency of tails, logarithm base 2 of q of t. And so this is equal to m times the amount of information. I'll keep getting tempted to call it magical, but I don't believe in magic. So this mathematical formula for the information is just really a way of counting number of possibilities. We look at the number of possible ways of getting exactly m sub h heads. We take its logarithm, that's the number of bits of information that are in this particular sequence. And we find that it's equal to m, the total number of flips, times this quantity, the information. So just to summarize, the fundamental formula of information theory is that the amount of information, also the amount of entropy, is equal to, if I have two possibilities, it's just minus q of heads, log q of heads, minus q of tails, log q of tails. And if I have more probabilities, so let's call them k possible outcomes, then the amount of information is just equal to minus the sum of the possible outcomes, I is equal to 1 to k, q of I, logarithm to the base 2 of q of I. And we just get this from counting the number of possibilities that go into constructing these frequencies. And this extremely useful formula is the basis for all of information theory, including the mathematical theory of communication, including the theory of computation.